All right guys, so for dinner, we are having homemade beef stroganoff. So for this recipe, you're gonna need some egg noodles, 12 ounces. This is 16 ounces, so I probably won't be using all of these. A small onion, 1 pound of ground beef, 8 ounces of sour cream, 2 tablespoons of butter, a can of cream of mushroom, 2 cups of beef broth, and then 3 tablespoons of all-purpose flour. And then this recipe also calls for mushrooms, but since I am the only one that likes mushrooms, I will not be adding it to this recipe. Oh, and salt and pepper. You're gonna need some salt and pepper. All right, so first things first is we are going to fill a pot full of water for our egg noodles, and then we are gonna melt butter with our onion and then brown our ground beef. So now we're going to take a large skillet. We're gonna add 2 tablespoons of butter. And then once that's melted, we're going to add our small onion and saute it in our pan. And then once that's done, we're gonna take it out, put it on a plate, and then brown our ground beef. So once the meat was done, I sprinkled the flour all over the top, added the beef broth, and now I'm just going to bring this back to a simmer and let it thicken up a little bit. And then once it thickens up, we're gonna add our onions. And you guys saw I got the noodles going, and also I have some peas heating up in this pot over here. And then once this thickens up, I'm going to add the 8 ounces of sour cream, and then I'm just gonna add a little bit of the cream of mushroom. I think I said a whole can earlier, but I'm just going to add it until it's thick enough and kind of like where I want it to be. Guys, so for dinner tonight, I am making chicken parm. I'll be sure to leave all the ingredients, like the exact measurements, down below, but you're going to need some grated Parmesan, of course, some marinara or spaghetti sauce, some panko breadcrumbs, I'm using Italian, 2 eggs, garlic powder, salt and pepper, 2 chicken breasts that I'm actually going to cut in half, some shredded mozzarella, and whatever pasta you want, I'm using thin spaghetti. So like I said, I'm first going to cut this in half, and I think I have to preheat my oven to, I need to double check, but I think it's 400. I think it's 400. All right, so I went ahead and cut my chicken breast in half. I have my egg mixture right here. You're just gonna take the 2 eggs, salt and pepper, mix it together. In this bowl, you're gonna add your breadcrumbs, Parmesan, and garlic powder. And then I have a pan over here that I just sprayed a little bit of oil in so the chicken doesn't stick. And then I have some water heating up over here for the pasta. So now you're going to take your chicken, dip it into your egg, and then your breadcrumbs, and then into the pan. So now we are going to put this in the oven for 20 to 25 minutes because we're gonna flip it once the timer goes off. All right, so the chicken is done. I'm just gonna spoon some of the marinara sauce on top, actually the rest of it from the jar. I'm heating up. My noodles are almost done. I have some green beans and garlic. Oh, I need to put the garlic bread in there. But like I said, I'm gonna put the marinara sauce on top and then sprinkle some mozzarella on top. Okay, so for this next recipe, I am gonna be making some crock pot Mississippi chicken. I have some boneless, skinless chicken thighs that I'm about to braise in my pan really quickly before I put it into the crock pot. You don't have to do this, this is optional, but it gives that crispiness and extra flavor. So I'm gonna do that, and then I'm gonna put it in the crock pot. You're gonna need a packet of brown gravy, a packet of ranch. You're going to slice up some butter because you're just gonna be putting, you're pretty much gonna be putting everything in the crock pot. So once I get the chicken thighs done, I'm gonna put them in here, sprinkle the two packets, put a couple slices of butter on each piece of chicken, and then you're just gonna add however many peppers that you want to, and then I usually put like a little splash of the juice from the peppers in there as well. So I'm gonna do that really quick, very easy. You can do any kind of side you want with this recipe. We're gonna do mashed potatoes tonight with probably broccoli. Anyways, I'm gonna go ahead and get this started. I'm just gonna cook it for a couple minutes on both sides and then put everything in the crock pot. A really crazy busy day. Frank actually ended up finishing dinner, so this is how the Mississippi chicken turned out.
I already tried a piece, it's so good.
Wait, is it your first time trying it? I think it's the first time I made it. Or no,
it's
I made
the
it.
First time you've made it.
Oh, you've had it before another time.
I had it like a long time ago at the fire station.
Yeah,
but it's been
so
like
good.
Several years. But like, I'm telling you,
it's really so good. Yes. So the kids will actually be having something different because it is a little bit spicy, but they'll be having the rest of the food. So Frank made some homemade mashed potatoes. Some steamed broccoli, so good. And the gravy that we made earlier, the brown gravy mix, actually made a gravy. So we put some on top of our mashed potatoes, some peppers. These are really good after they've been cooked. I'm like starving right now. I didn't have lunch. I'm out of breath because we've been running around like crazy, but I'm ready to dig in. All right, guys. So for dinner tonight, we are having salmon, rice pilaf, and asparagus. But the first thing that I'm gonna do is marinate the salmon, and I wanna share with you guys my go-to favorite recipe for a marinade. So I've already mixed everything together. It's 1/3 cup of soy sauce, 1/3 cup of water, 1/3 cup of brown sugar, and then 1/4 cup of vegetable oil. And I just mixed it all together until the sugar is dissolved and right there. But the first thing that I'm gonna do is I'm going to salt and pepper it, and then also put some lemon pepper, and then I'll put the marinade all over the top and leave it in the fridge until it is time to cook it. You can grill it, but I think tonight, babe, do you wanna grill this or do you wanna bake it? Would it be easier to probably bake?
Either one, I could probably okay. grill it or-
We haven't decided, so you could do it either way. If you wanna bake it, grill it, however you wanna do it, but this is how I always make it. It's just the pepper, and it's a pretty simple recipe, and you could even do this overnight if you wanted to. All right, guys, so the salmon has been marinating all day. All right, guys, so the salmon has been marinating all day. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take two fillets and put them on the sheets of aluminum foil, because we're going to wrap it up and then put it in the oven, if that makes sense. So two on each. We have some rice pilaf going on over here, And actually, let me just take the camera down. We are taking the easy way out with some rice pilaf. And then we have some asparagus in here. Frank, you put what? Olive oil, lemon pepper, and pepper.
And garlic salt.
So that's gonna bake for about 20 minutes. Alright, so we're just gonna set them right on here. I'm coming, Scarlett. Alright, so here is the finished product. Here's how the salmon turned out. We have the rice pilaf, the roasted asparagus. So if your fish is usually dry, try it with the aluminum foil, wrap it up, and let me know how it turns out. But I am now ready to dig in.